Okay, so I'm kind of going to show you how I made this effect today. And we'll be starting with how I got these colors. And if you long press on the screen, it looks like this. Okay, so there's a few ways that you can change the colors in Spark, but the way that I do it is with this guy. Ooh, look at it. Beautiful. This is called the base lookup table. And if you're familiar with LUTs, then you'll know what this is doing. Put them into any editing software, whether it's photo editing or video editing, and you can mess with the settings to change the way that it looks. So it's really cool because you can just edit it and then whack it into Spark and it will put those same edits and effects on your image. But the things that it doesn't, it's not all effects, it's only sort of things like hue, value, saturation, contrast, all of that kind of stuff. But you can do some pretty weird stuff like this and you'll get some interesting outcomes. Yeah. So you can get really experimental and you can actually put anything in, any image. It doesn't have to be an edited version of this. You can just whack in any image and it will give you something. So experiment, enjoy. But the way that I made the colors for this effect is actually really simple. All I did was just open up GIMP, which is basically like a free Photoshop. And I just, went down to, I just flipped it horizontally. So very simple. And then you can just export it and drag it into Spark AR. In fact, before we drag it in, let's open up a canvas and insert a rectangle. I'm going to go down and give the rectangle a material. And I'm just going to open up the texture of this material in the patch editor and drag in this patch that I downloaded. I'll have the link in the description. And it's called the Fast Color LUT. And I got it from Josh Beckwith. You should check out his channel. He does some really good tutorials as well. And then we'll make a patch out of the color table. So then we'll drag it up and we'll start connecting it. Okay, oh dear. Let's keep going. Uh-oh, this isn't looking good, but it needs the final magic ingredient. So just go up to the camera, go over to texture extraction, and then down in our assets, we now have the camera texture. And we'll connect the RGBA to the texture. And voila, magic. So now to make this fill the screen, we'll go back over to the rectangle and click fill parent. Now it's nice and full. All right, so then you wanna go over to the directional light and we're just gonna change it to a really vibrant, we're gonna change the color to a really vibrant red. And then you'll see if you go over now, if you go over to the ambient light and bring the intensity all the way down, it's just black and red. If you bring it all the way up, you get this kind of these like cyber bright neon kind of colors. So what I wanted was a screen tap to change. I wanted it to sort of animate this intensity from going all the way down, all the way up, and then do it again. It goes so you could sort of almost like turning the light on and off. So I decided to go over long press and then I connected it with a pulse and connected that pulse to an animation. And then I connected the animation to a transition. And what a transition does is basically just transitions from one value to a different value. On some patches, you can just sort of right click, go into type and then change the type. So I just wanted number. I wanted to, so you connect that to the intensity and then I change the end to 100 just to be fully, so the light's all the way on and change the duration to 2 seconds so it's not too quick. And the curve is kind of just the animation style, so whether it like slowly ends or quickly, it's kind of just different animation styles. So you can just mess around and see which one suits yours, but now I'm just sort of testing it out and
checking that it works. But this is when I realized that actually I'd made a mistake. And because what was happening was I would long press and it would come on, but then when I would let go, it would turn off. And I didn't want that. I wanted it to stay on and then turn off when I did another long press. So what I did to fix it was I went in, I moved these ones along, and after the screen tap or the long press, I just added another pulse and then a switch. And that made it so that the long press was acting like a switch, and I preferred that. But maybe your effect fits the version where you press down and then you let go and it turns off. So if you wanted that one, you could use the previous patch setup, but I went for this. Okay, now we're going to go in for the glowing eyes. So with the glowing eyes, you want to insert a face mesh and it'll automatically add a face tracker. But you'll see we have a bit of a problem. The face mesh is actually behind the rectangle and the canvas. See, it's almost like a screen in front of it. And to make it see-through, we need to see which material it is, go to the material, and then change its advanced render options to, we need to untick this right to depth. And then you can see through that material. So then we want to go to the texture of the face mesh and we want to add a material. We're going to call that eyes. And then we're going to want to drag in another patch that I downloaded. I'll include the link for this one as well. And then drag it into your patch editor. And then get your eyes texture and drag that in and change the color to, I went with red, but you can't actually see it yet because automatically face meshes have the eyes checked to have like a hole where the eyes can see through. So you want to uncheck that. And then I changed the blend mode to add. And that gives it a kind of glow. It makes it sort of like a little bit see-through and it gives it kind of like a glowing brightness to it.
Right, so now I'm going to go through the horns. They're pretty simple. They're just like a low poly mesh. I'm not going to go too much into the 3D modeling side of it, but basically it's just got a smaller horn and then a bigger horn. It's easier to see actually if you change to this lighting. So you can see there's like two, a smaller one and then a bigger one. And their material is just a physically based shader type. Red color. Nothing too crazy, just the blend mode is add to give it that glow, again with the same with the eyes to give it that kind of glow. And the way that I made it so that you can tap them and they grow is actually pretty simple. It's to make it so that it taps. Because when I'm tapping over here, it's doing something different. So the way that I made it specifically, the way that I made the horns themselves into a button, was I made this plane, and it's actually invisible. You'll see the material's called Invisible. And if I look at Invisible, it has a 1% opacity. So you can't really see it, but if I was to bring it up, you would see, so that is the button, and then you can just create a patch out of that, which will give you this purple object, and then you can do create an object tap, and just connect that up as the object that needs to be tapped to trigger
the rest of this animation, which is them growing. So if I tap outside, it does the face, and inside, it does the horns. And you'll see that I've made it a little bit bigger than the horns because, you know, on a phone screen, it's quite small. And, you know, when you're sort of pressing, you want to give them a good chance of getting it. Or you could make a very small button as a sort of like secret. If you can find the button, it could do something. I've been thinking about doing it so you've got different buttons all over the face and you can like tap to change the style of tattoo, like in different areas. So you could like tap through different designs there and then there. So you could like fully customize it. So I might make that soon. But the way that I did the animation of the horns growing is similar to what I showed you before with the animation to the transition to bring the light up and down. But instead of just going up and down, it's starting. I've dragged in the scale and the position. So the way that you do that is you go to the... Okay, so let's just bring that down again. So then to do the animation, you can just click here and it will bring these out and you can connect them to the transition and you'll say you want it to start. So, you know, I wanted the scale to start at that size and at this position. And then when I made it grow, I realized that it was too close to the eye. So I moved it up a little bit. So the animation is basically size growing and then slightly moving up the forehead a little bit just to make room for the growth. So very simple. The bigger ones are going from size 1 to 2, and the smaller one is going from 0.7 to 1.7. And I used a bounce curve because I liked the way it kind of boom, kind of just like grows. It's a bit like a I just liked it. So these are the positions that's moving, you know, they're just like slight movements from sort of like 7 to 9 on the y-axis, which is the up and down one. So yeah, it's very simple. So the invisible button and the animation, and it all comes together to give you this effect. Okay, so now I'm going to go through all of these different designs. And it's pretty simple the way that I got, and I'm also going to talk about this shine, the way that I got the tattoo designs and stuff. I mean, most of them I'd already made for other effects and stuff, so I just like pulled from my library of that. And then some of the other ones I just thought would look good and decided to add them as well. And it's a very simple screen tap to a counter, like in my first tutorial, but it's just got a whole lot of these options because there is so much choice. And then the shine is very simple. The material for making it shiny is just so you just make a head. You'll add a face mesh, add the material, and then make the materials shader type physically based, make the color black, and then put it on screen, and then that removes all the black and just leaves a reflective, clear reflective thing. But then before you can start seeing the shine, you need to change the metallic and the roughness values. So once you start playing around with them, you'll get the higher number on the roughness, the obviously more rough it is and stuff. So the more I find the less rough, the more the kind of, you see, it's like a really small part of the light is being reflected and stuff, whereas it gets like a bigger. Yeah, so you can just mess around with it and see how it affects it and get it to how you like it. And yeah, I think obviously the light shining effect and stuff is a little bit played out now, but it can still look good as a nice little accent.
Cool, well, that's it for the video. I hope you learned something. If you want me to go more in depth in something, let me know in the comments. And if you want to use my effects, you can just follow me on Instagram. It's @onomatters. Peace.